Hey, how's it going, guys? Mr. Boss for the win here, and in today's GTA video, we're going to be taking a look at some interesting bits of GTA 6 news and reports, including what a finance company has to say regarding the release date of GTA 6, what happened to our mysterious cryptic leaker on the GTA forum site now that March is over, and one of the characters, voice actors, making a mysterious move recently. So let's begin with some financial company giving us an overview on when they believe Grand Theft Auto 6 is going to come out. And this is interesting for a couple of reasons, because as gamers, we often only tend to focus on the game itself and how it relates to things that we will be able to experience, like the gameplay, the story, the location, the characters. But there's a whole other side to creating video games that's often overlooked, and that's the business side of things. Now, sometimes the business side of things and the gaming side of things merge, particularly with Grand Theft Auto Online, Red Dead Online, with the introduction of microtransactions like shark cards and gold bars. So in a way, we sort of see that introduced, but for the most part, the business strategy of making these games is often left to the experts, and often left to the people overseeing the companies that are making the games. And so there was an interesting capital funds group called Intrepid Capital. And I'll leave a link to their site in the description if you guys are interested. Essentially, they are like an investment advisory group. They say they are focused on long-term, deep, fundamental company analysis and disciplined valuation process. And one of the things they've actually done is an outline of Take-Two Interactive, which you guys know is the parent company of Rockstar Games. And so this is actually an older report that they've done. In fact, this was actually released on June 30th, 2019. So I don't know who actually discovered this or who came across this, but this has actually been published for a bit now. But anyways, the company had this to say. They said, viewed over a longer period of time or in a year when one of its franchise title is released, a company like Take-Two is actually quite cheap. Grand Theft Auto V was released in 2013 and earned $800 million in its first day and $1 billion within 3 days of release, becoming the fastest-selling entertainment product in history. And while a release date has yet to be confirmed, we expect Grand Theft Auto VI will hit the market shortly after the new generation of gaming consoles are released, which is likely a late 2020 or early 2021 event. Okay, so that's very interesting because this company is looking at GTA 6's release date in a completely different light. They're not focusing on the things that we might focus on, but instead, they're monitoring like Take-Two Interactive's value and how things are looking in the stock market, which is certainly an interesting approach, one that I can't speak too much on because I'm not an expert in that field, but it is interesting to hear what they have to say. Now, since that article has come out, we have gotten some more concrete news on when the next generation consoles are going to be coming out. Both the PlayStation 5 and Xbox Series X are scheduled for holiday 2020. In fact, I think the PlayStation 5 is supposed to come out around Thanksgiving, so I would imagine the Xbox would follow suit, coming out around that time as well. And so these financial experts are predicting that it will come out shortly after the new generation. Now, the only problem with that, as things currently stand, is we haven't heard anything from Rockstar regarding GTA 6, and unless they're going to pull like a Bethesda, or they announce a game and then release it 6 months later, which would be completely against what we've seen Rockstar do in the past for Grand Theft Auto games, I think it would be unlikely that we see GTA 6 in 2020 or even 2021 at this point. I think the earliest it could happen now is likely 2022. And by then, the PS5 and Xbox Series X would have been out for about a year or so, which would have given Rockstar plenty of time to work out many of the kinks and bugs of the new system, and also allow them to have more of a hands-on experience with those consoles, potentially even refining Grand Theft Auto 6 even more. So this, of course, is something we are going to monitor closely, but just note that even financial expertise companies are jumping in the discussion of when Grand Theft Auto 6 is going to be coming out, because believe it or not, it does have a big impact on the stock market and finances and everything like that. So that is something that I will keep you guys posted on. Now, speaking of Grand Theft Auto 6 and Rockstar not saying anything yet, as you guys know, we've been monitoring a set of cryptic leaks from a supposed insider on the GTA forum site saying that something was going to happen in March, that Rockstar was going to do some sort of announcement or reveal for GTA 6. Well, as you guys know, it's now April 1st, which means March has come and gone, and we have seen nothing from Rockstar regarding Grand Theft Auto 6. So, a couple of things about that. The first is that this user on the GTA forum site that was saying all these cryptic messages and stating that Rockstar was going to reveal something has actually been banned, or at least been put on some suspension. I don't know how everything works on that website, but they have like a notice next to their name saying busted, which I think means that if you have that, you have a banned account. So it looks like the admins or moderators of that site, they held by their word saying that they would ban the user if nothing happened in the month of March. And as far as why nothing happened, I don't think we will ever know. At least in my personal opinion, I think that this person who said they were an insider or had insider information has been somewhat correct in the past. I feel like they actually did have information, although that information might have been old, or Rockstar might have actually changed their plans given the uncertainty of the world right now. Honestly, there's too many variables to look at here to say, you know, this is what happened and this is why, you know, the game wasn't announced. All we know is at this point in time, I think everyone is still going to be on high alert because of this, because I still believe he had good intentions. His information might have just been either old or Rockstar might have changed their mind. But for now, month of March has come and gone. We saw no announcement made for Grand Theft Auto 6, and I don't know what to expect next. I'll obviously be sure to keep you guys posted if any more information comes out about this, or if, you know, some other leaks start to develop. But for now, we're just going to be anticipating the day in which we see an official announcement from Rockstar. And the last thing we're going to be talking about in this video today is a follow-up to something we discussed a couple of days ago. So remember Jorge Consejo, who actually had GTA 6 listed in his resume? Well, remember he also put out an interesting tweet sort of addressing people asking him, you know, if he was involved in GTA 6, does he know anything about GTA 6? Remember, he ended up saying this. He said, "Dear friends, while I read every message from you, please know that because of contract stipulations, sometimes I'm unable to comment on certain projects. Please don't feel ignored or unseen. I appreciate and value every single one of you." And then a heart emoji and a peace sign emoji. And what's interesting is just a couple of days after he ended up making that tweet, he actually removed Grand Theft Auto 6 from his resume. How interesting is that? Remember, that GTA 6 listing was in his resume since he added it, but mysteriously it was removed. So that begs the question, did he remove it himself just because he wanted to get rid of the constant pestering from people asking him about Grand Theft Auto 6 and his involvement? Or did he actually hear from Rockstar saying, "Hey, you've got to remove this. We don't want you to say that you're working on GTA 6. You're not supposed to say that that's happening." And this sort of follows suit to another supposed GTA 6 voice actor that did the same thing, Tim Neff. He actually removed his Grand Theft Auto 6 involvement from his resume as well. Now it just says Grand Theft Auto, whereas before it specifically said GTA 6. So I wonder if Rockstar is cracking down on their voice actors and motion capture artists accidentally saying they're working on GTA 6 before they were allowed to say something. And again, this wouldn't be the first time Rockstar was cracking down on stuff like that. Remember that mysterious countdown reveal live stream the other day? Well, it looks like Rockstar shut that down too. So Rockstar definitely has their ears to the internet right now. It seems like they're focusing on the things that people are talking about and that are gaining traction. And if it relates to GTA 6, I definitely think they're monitoring it, because something happened with Jorge Canseco and now he's removed that from his resume. So just something we will also monitor as well. But I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments down below. Let me know what you think about everything we discussed in this video today regarding GTA 6's release date, at least according to financial experts, our mysterious leaker on the GTA forum site finally getting the boot, and Rockstar forcing one of their voice actors to change their resume, or at least the voice actor changing it himself. Let me know your thoughts, opinions, and more in the comments down below. I'd love to hear from you guys down there. If you guys did go on to enjoy this video, though, a like rating would, of course, be awesome. And be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new, or you want to stay up to date on all the latest GTA and Red Dead Redemption videos that I'm doing here on my channel. And be sure to ring that notification bell as well. Sometimes YouTube just doesn't work, and if you ring that bell, you'll always be guaranteed to be notified when new videos arrive. But of course, as always, guys, thank you all so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.